Welcome back to part two of the Hibs Club. Well, they're irreverent, sometimes abusive, controversial, but never dull. And most football clubs have at least one. They're frequently the only platform which fans can voice their views. And Katrina Harvey's been talking to the men who can sometimes be a thorn in the flesh of the Hibs establishment.
The fans love them, but they're often feared by those in charge. We're talking fanzines here, and arguably Hibs have one of the best in the UK. Civil servant Sean Allen and his pal John Campbell are the two men currently responsible for Scotland's longest-running fanzine, Mass Hibsteria. Nobody is safe from their sharp comments and humorous observations, but letting the fans voice their opinions is the top priority.
For every person that writes to us, we will print what they write to us, assuming that it's not libelous or it doesn't contain too many swear words, we'll print it. So we think the fans have a voice, and most of these things generate a response. There's some good debates going on just now.
It's there to give the fans a voice. They don't have any other medium to put their views forward. They can write to the programme, they can write to the newspapers, but those letters are going to be severely censored and edited. And, I mean, all we're going to do is cut out profanities. They can basically say what they want to say in the fanzine. And as I say, there's no other options for them apart from to write to us and get things off their chest and say what they want to say. So we give them that.
Every new copy of the fanzine is sent directly to the club so that the players and members of the board can find out exactly what the punters are thinking. The reaction can be mixed, but any reaction is regarded as a success.
I think that towards the end of last season, when the club were toiling and they were going to be in the playoffs, we made a suggestion to the club that we should perhaps consider putting buses on to take fans to matches. The club reacted in a positive way to that and did that, and we think we'd like to think we had some input to them doing that.
But although Easter Road Chat fills the bulk of the publication, the other function of the fanzine is crafted with real passion, ripping right into the opposition. And not surprisingly, the other Edinburgh club takes most of the stick.
We don't hate them so much, we just feel sorry for them. How can they touch us? You know, there's nothing they can say about us. We have the best team, the best fanzine, the best stadium. What can they say about Hibs?
They're rivals for many years. Besides, they set themselves up for it so many times that it's so easy to take the mickey out of Rangers, because they're a target for everyone and basically anyone else that's not connected to Hibs.
Trainspotting writer Irvin Welsh was a regular contributor to the fanzine, which still has a large pool of writers who meet in the pub monthly to run through ideas.
Meetings are another big plus point. You know, we have to get, we've got a team of really talented writers, we have to get them together in between each issue. We meet in a pub close to the ground, and it's about 5 minutes business and 2.5 hours drinking. You know, they're good.
But it's John and Sean who spend the hours in front of computers every week shaping the mag for the final print. It's a lot of work, but they reckon it's well worthwhile.
It's a labour of love, it has to be said. That's what they do it for. They don't make any money out of it. Any money that comes in, we try to play back into him by giving things like season tickets as prizes and competitions, which of course means the money goes back to the club again.
When people come along, they give you a pound to the fans and they say, by the way, that last issue was really great, or that was a terrific article, or I liked something you wrote and I'm going to write you a letter or send you an article. It's immense satisfaction you get from that. It's really good, so it's well worthwhile.
The dreaded fanzine. I quite like the idea, though, of having 2.5 hours of drinking time before we sit down to write anything.